Hi, it's Carl from Let's Make Games. Welcome to the next episode of Let's Pyxel. In this episode, we're going to look at creating our tiling terrain textures, ready for the next video where we'll implement a better map class. So the idea is that we're going to need more than the three images that we've got now, and we want them all to be in a single image rather than split up across multiple images. This will make managing it much easier in the game engine. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start with a canvas that's 10 tiles wide and high, and I'm working with a standard pixel height and width of 32. So when we create a new document in Pyxel Edit, make sure we're selecting a tiled document or animation and click create. Now this gives us a 10 by 10 grid, which gives us the option of having up to 100 different tiles. So we've got a grid, and now Pyxel Edit has quite a handy tiling feature, which just allows us to draw multiple tiles in one go. So what we're going to do, firstly, we're going to press tab, and you can see now, if I zoom in just a little bit, we have these dots. Now this is the tile reference. So you can see here, here's our first tile, which is tile one. If you click this, it'll give you the tile place at all. And you can see tile zero, and we can paint tile zero into these. So then we can go back into painting, and now when we paint, it'll duplicate across everything that we have. First thing we can do is start with a grass texture. We need to create one for the center, one where it joins the dirt, and then for the corners where it joins the dirt as well. Let's get started. The first thing we can do, we'll start in the center. We'll flood fill this with green. So if we use the select tool, select there, and we'll pick a darkish green from here. Probably more of a brown colour as a base. No, it needs to be quite a dark, darkish brown, not very bright. Then we'll use the fill tool, and we'll just fill that. So as you can see now, it's starting to fill in here. So what we're going to do now is pick a green. So we want to do some grass. So with the pen tool, we'll go to green, we'll pick a darkish green. Now, this could be pretty random, so we can get up. This is all we're going to do. Go up a few and off to the right. This was sort of done in Stardew Valley. No right or wrong, just place them where you need them to be. And you can see that's starting to tile now. Just keep going. So now we have our base done. We can sort of see what that's going to look like. What we're going to need to do now is add some shadows and highlights to this. So what we're going to do is, in our colour picker, in our shading, we're going to go a shade down. And what we're going to do is just, on the bottom of each of these, we're just going to add a dark pixel. So now we've added a bit of shadow to the bottom. We're going to add a highlight to the top of them. So in here, we're going to go up a shade. Now that's the shade. And so now what we can do is add to some of them. Some of them we're just going to do that, but on the longer ones, we're going to do both of them like this. We want to keep it random. We don't want each one to be the same. So now we've got our highlighted grass here. What we can do is fill in some of these gaps with some green. So what we can do, we're going to pick up that colour. So you can right click and we'll pick up this colour. And what we can do, we're just going to put a couple of blocks. So I'm thinking that brown is too dark. You sort of lose the detail. Because that's sort of how we're going to see it in the game. So I think if we brighten it up a little bit, that might help us. So in our colour picker, we're going to select that colour and we're going to bring it up a shade. And then we're using F to get to the fill tool. We'll just do that. And that's too bright. So we'll undo that. What we'll do, we'll make the grass a bit lighter. So there's no quick way of doing this. Let's go up a shade. And then this one, we'll pick that up. We'll go up a shade. We'll make sure we get the right colours in before we carry on at the top. And then this one, move up a shade as well. So we select that colour. Move up a shade. And we'll colour there. So now we'll just draw in the middle of each of these. So we can now see in the preview, this is looking a bit better. So I'm just going to carry on doing this. We'll select our middle colour. Now we'll take our top colour and add the final highlights. So there we've got a grass. If you wanted to make it denser, you could just add more strands. So now what we're going to do is start adding dirt to the edge and start blending it in. So the way we're going to do this is actually we're going to duplicate this tile here by pressing this button. Now with this tool, we can place tile one here. So what we can do now, with tile one there, if we get the pen tool and take a copy of this, and we draw about halfway through a line, we start doing this. Make sure not to go over the other tiles next to it. And what we can do, we're just going to remove some of the grass on here to make it look like it's just blending in. So we'll just remove the odd one and remove that one, that one, that one. The eraser, we'll just get rid of that. So with this tile, we're just going to put another one there and another one there. You can see how that looks. We're going to remove this one. So that's a bit of a dead end. So what we're going to do is clear this and we're just going to do a little bit more. So as we were doing the grass before, what we can do is just add so now we've got that, we're going to add a bit of definition to the dirt here. So with that selected, if we select a slightly darker colour, and if we just paint in some lines, don't forget to go across them to make sure. There's an edge. So now what we're going to do is basically the same around here, apart from we're going to make this one into a corner. So with that one selected, we're going to press duplicate and have that tile be the corner. So back with the pen tool, we're going to select this colour again, and now we're going to paint out this corner like so. And we're going to carry on adding some shadow detail here. So now the next one, we're going to remove some of this horizontal one. So we're going to go back to this one, which is there. And we need to actually duplicate that one, which is going to be this one. And we'll place that here. Then with the pen tool, as we have with the others, we're going to draw out this section. All the way down, and then we're going to remove just bits so it just looks a bit thinner on the edges. Then remove this. So now what we're going to do is duplicate this frame that we've just done and put it on this one to make the opposite corner. So take that one and we'll press duplicate. So now that one's there, and we'll place that tile here, and then we'll carry on drawing in this corner. So we'll thin out some of this with that, the lighter color. Now we're basically going to just do what we've done for this side across this side here, and we'll be able to draw some maps. So I'm just going to carry on doing that. So on duplicate this one, so press duplicate, and I'm going to place tile 5 there. And then finally, the last one, we're going to take that one, which is this tile, and duplicate that one, which gives us this one. So now we can go back in and just finish off that corner, and we're just going to remove this. Now the final one here is a duplicate of number 1. So if we select tile reference 1 here, and we're going to make a duplicate of that one. So we select that one, place that here, and we start drawing in the final corner, one of the final corners. So now we have our 9 textures for doing this. So the whole idea is, if I zoom out a little bit, what we can do, I can grab that tile and we can paint in our corners. 4, 1, put a corner there. So let's add a blank tile and let's just get rid of some of these. So we've got our 9. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn this tile into a dirt tile. So what I'm going to do, make sure this tiles, I'm just going to paint those four as that. Then we're going to grab the select tool. Select that, grab the fill tool. Obviously we've covered off the map because we covered, painted it in 9. But the idea is now what we're going to do is with our pen tool, grab this colour. I'm going to start we'll work on this dirt texture a bit better in a minute. It's got this sort of wavy pattern that we don't want. What we're going to want to do is arrange these grass tiles in a way so we have to put a corner in like so. So now you can see we can draw our maps however we want. So let's do a bit of work on our dirt tile, so which is number 9 on here. So what we're going to do with the pen tool, we're going to start adding a bit of a highlight like we did with the grass. So if we select the colour and we'll go up a shade and we'll press OK. Now the light we had, it was coming from the top, so what we're going to do is just start putting these in here. So now you can see we're starting to get a bit of definition in our dirt. And also what we're going to do is do this across our grass tiles as well. So you'll see if I do this tile here, it will automatically come across to all the others. So say the keys keep it all random. And if we need to change the shape of some of these, we will do. See, this dark spot here is a bit big, so we're gonna remove some of that. And the same. Let's remove those so we can see a little bit better. And we'll just finish colouring in the rest here. And looking at this, you can see these diagonals aren't really working, they stand out far too much. So as I say, we can change the shape of some of these. So if we do that, and we've still got this here. So what we can do is draw that out. Still too many diagonals, so just ensure that we've done all of these. Right, so now we just need to do it up here. So now we've got our dirt tiles done and the highlights have been added around the grass as well. We can start thinking about water. So we're going to have to create a new tile. And what we'll do, we'll place that in this section here. We will organise these properly into the grid later, but while we're doing this, this will help us a lot. So in here, we're going to use a select tool and we're going to fill in. We're going to pick a blue, fill that in, So what we're going to do is add some waves. Now this is where the tiling feature of Pyxel Edit really does help. If we pick a lighter shade and we start drawing in a wave like so, just make that a bit neater, and start in the corner and come down. And if we make this a bit wider and in here, then what we're going to do is pick up a darker colour than this one and do a wave in the opposite direction. Like so, and then if we just fill in there like so. So now what we can do is make a duplicate. So we've duplicated our tile so we can start doing the edging. And what I'm going to do to get some of this dirt, I'm going to take the top section of it so it matches to the bottom. So with the select tool, I'm going to take probably about 12 pixels. We can take a copy of that, place tile, now I've duplicated that, place tile 11 here. Then when we paste in this, and we'll put that in, press enter, we have that. So what we can do is deselect, and with the paint tool, I'm just going to select this colour. So what I'm going to do with this is now paint in some crashing, like so. Then we're going to duplicate that one and place it here. And then with the selection tool, what we're going to do is take a selection of the back set of pixels, take a copy of that, make sure that we've put that as number 12. Then with that copied, we're going to paste that into number 12. And then with the pen tool, deselect and paint in here. So again, we'll duplicate another water tile, select that one and place it here. Using select tool, we'll take the back edge of that and place that in here. And as we did with the grass, we're just going to do this all the way around for the water. And so we have a pool of water now. Now we do have some missing tiles with the water, if we wanted the water to come around this way, for example. So say for example we needed the water to come over here, we need to put, let's grab the right one, we need a corner piece, because we can't join up, so let's put piece there. What we'll do, we'll take that one there, we'll duplicate it, and we'll put it here. Let's put that in there, and we'll just draw in the dirt. So we'll place this tile in here now. We'll delete that one. We'll duplicate that one, which will be this one. And then with our pen tool, we'll add the dirt in like so. So now we have that corner, we need to do that for each side. So let's draw out a pool a bit. So we put that there. Put that there. That can be that one. We'll just grab
on dirt, put that there. So we've arranged the tiles how we need them, and you can see a bit more clearly now that we've done this corner that we need to do these corners. So we can do these the same way. So if we take that one there, which is because they're all the same, and we make a duplicate, and we place that one here. Then with the pen tool, take a copy of that, we draw in our corner, fill that in. There's one corner. We'll do the same again. So we'll duplicate, put that one there. We'll just draw in another corner. And then the final corner. And there we have our water tiles. So with this, we're quickly painting a map now. So we'll start with our water. We can just drag this in. Now let's fill some of these in. So we need some bottoms there. There. We need some of this across here. Apart from that, we can paint some dirt in here. So we'll start painting in our island. So the corner there and one there. We've got this curve, so let's put that there, like so, but we need to cut one of our corner pieces, which is that one. So now we have the base of the water painted in. We'll put a little pool inside here as well. So, with that done, put some grass around the island, and actually we'll have those as paths. And so there we have our new terrain tiles, which we can paint however we want. And so, to export this, what we're going to do is going to go File, Export Tile Set. Scale 1, we're going to put this on the desktop. This is just going to be our terrain texture. So terrain underscore texture. I'm going to keep it as a PNG. And we'll press Save. So now on the desktop, we now have an image like so. And this is what we use to build the next map in the next episode of our How to Make a Game series, in the next episode where we actually build a better map class. See you in the next video.